Josh and Jean, this couple is seeking at least $15,000 in damages. They say their son still suffers from nightmares and that his suffering will continue into the future.
In a very hard thrust, she went down, and I screamed, and she screamed.
That was Suzanne Cannell of Somersworth, the day after a killer whale attacked and drowned its trainer at SeaWorld in Florida. Now, 6 months later, she and her husband are suing the theme park, saying their 10-year-old son suffered emotional distress from what he saw. The lawsuit says 10-year-old Bobby Cannell, seen here, suffered mental scars that have manifested to physical impairments, which will be with him for the rest of his life. After the incident, the family was interviewed in their Florida hotel room. They were celebrating Bobby's 10th birthday.
I heard my mom scream and stuff, so I was wondering what happened.
The Cannells took this home video of the 12,000-pound killer whale moments before it killed veteran trainer Don Brenchot. The lawsuit claims that prior to the attack, Bobby bonded with the trainer and then watched in horror as the whale dragged 40-year-old Brenchot underwater. And it says that during that time, Bobby cried so profoundly that his face turned red and then a shade of blue. The suit goes on to say the owners of SeaWorld were negligent because they knew the killer whale was a dangerous and unpredictable wild animal and that it had previously killed two people. The day after the attack, Todd Cannell said as they waited for workers to free Brenchot, he contemplated jumping in himself.
Nobody would dive in, and you know, I was thinking, geez, should I dive in?
And the family filed this lawsuit just one day after OSHA fined SeaWorld $75,000 for damages relating to the attack. And OSHA has said that SeaWorld is not commenting on this case. Reporting live in the newsroom, Kriya Sakikini, WMUR News 9.